And now we come to the last part of this video about the Born Haber Cycle. We are going to put the enthalpy changes to all the examples that we did in the previous part. Like in this picture here, we have six enthalpy changes pointing up, down, then a very big downward arrow, which is the lattice energy, if you remember. This is the pattern. This is the pattern if the anion is negative one. It's very important that you remember this because the first EA is negative. So C1 plus C2 will be lower than the C1 plus B2. And this is the pattern. Between A1 plus A2 to B1 plus B2, we have two arrow delta H atomization. We have two delta H atomization and one horizontal line in the middle, B1 plus A2. This is because you atomize the metal first, then you atomize the non-metal later. From B1 plus B2 becomes C1 plus B2 is because you ionize B1. So the first ID of B1. Maybe you need to add the second ID and so on. Then from C1 plus B2 to C1 plus C2, you do the first EA of B2, pointing down, and from C1 plus C2, you draw a long arrow downwards to D, which is the ionic compound and solid state. From A1 plus A2 to D is the delta HF. So that's the pattern. If the anion is negative 1, then this is, we use the example 1. Example 1, we did put all the substances on the previous part of this video for example 1. Then we put the arrow one by one. Solid plus half Cl2 gas. Element at standard state to pointing downwards, delta HF. Below is D, which is sodium chloride solid, ionic compound at solid state. Next arrow. We draw two arrow, delta H atomization, upwards of something which we are going to fill it up later. Then two more arrow, ionization energy pointing up and first EA pointing down. Then the last part is of course the lattice energy pointing down, very exothermic reaction. We check the coefficient of the cation and the anion, all of them are 1, so we don't need to put the coefficient into all this delta H. The charge of the cation is plus 1, that means we have only the first ID. The charge of the anion is minus 1. That means we have only the first EA, we don't have the second EA. And don't forget to put all the substances, atomization of sodium. We must put the substance there. Atomization of chlorine. First IE of sodium. First EA of chlorine. Delta HLE of sodium chloride. And don't forget, from element standard state to the ionic compound, from A1 plus A2 to D is delta HF of sodium chloride. So that's the first example. Now we do the second example. We did put the substances into the horizontal line. Now we continue with the arrow. Two arrow down, one very big downward arrow, then one small downward arrow. The small one, I think you remember by now, is delta HF, right? The big one is delta HLE. Remember to check the coefficient of the cation and the coefficient of the anion. The coefficient of the cation is 1, coefficient of the anion is 1. So we don't need to put any coefficient on all the delta H. Simple. The charge of the cation and the is plus 2. The charge of the anion is negative 2, which means we have the first and second IV. Also, we have the first and second EA. I mark there with the orange color for the second EA and second IV. We put all the arrow starting from A1 plus A2, from magnesium solid plus sulfur solid. Atomization of magnesium. So we go up by 1. Atomization of sulfur. First and second EA of magnesium. First and second EA of sulfur. Then from there down delta HLE, lattice energy of magnesium sulfide. And don't forget to complete the cycle from element standard state to ionic compound at solid state. Formation of magnesium sulfide. That's how you did it. That was example 2. Now we do example 3. Aluminium oxide, Al2O3. We already write down all the substances into the horizontal line. We are going to draw an arrow now, which means is the enthalpy changes. Starting from element standard state, 4 arrow up. 2 times delta H atomization of aluminium. We must multiply by 2 because we have 2 Al. 3 delta H atomization of oxygen because we have 3 oxygen. The next arrow, ionization energy. First, second, and third ionization energy of aluminium. Don't forget to multiply by 2, all of them, because we have 2 Al. We have first, second, and third. The reason is because Al is 3+. Next arrow, the fourth arrow. First and second EA of oxygen. Remember to multiply that by 3. We have 3 delta H first EA and 3 delta H second EA. Then downward arrow, delta H LE of Al2O3, the coefficient is always 1. And another downward arrow, delta HF of Al2O3, the coefficient is always 1. I rewrite this Born Haber cycle so that you are aware of possible mistake. I mark the coefficient with pink and green color. So you must remember when the delta H in 4th aluminium, you must multiply that by 2 because there is 2 aluminium. When the delta H in 4th oxygen, you must multiply by 3 because there are 3 oxygen. And I mark the second IE and third IE of aluminium because aluminium is 3+. So don't forget. I also mark there the second EA of oxygen because oxygen is 2-. That's the end of our video. hopefully you can understand this thing. This Born Haber Cycle is not difficult. You can do this. And if I think my video is quite clear, you can understand it. Thanks for watching my video.